Welcome to the guided notes for Introduction to the Human Body Systems. This unit will move very quickly, so let's review some guidelines of how to use these videos and complete these guided notes. We're going to complete the guided notes titled Levels of Organization, Structure, and Function today. Please pause this and get them out now if you haven't already. First, we'll complete the pyramid on the top left. The smallest, most numerous unit of structure in humans, in any organism, is the cell. Groups of cells make up tissues. Groups of tissues make up organs. Organs working together make up organ systems, and organ systems make up the organism. In this unit, humans. Right under the levels of organization pyramid are a series of descriptive sentences we'll complete next. Cells with similar function make up tissue. Tissues with similar function make up an organ. Organs with similar functions make up an organ system. All the organ systems combined make an organism. Next, we'll complete the section to the right, structure and function. You don't have to squeeze in everything, but the parts in red would be a good idea. Structure is how a thing, a part, is made and how it fits in with other related parts. Another term for structure is anatomy. Function is what a thing does, its job, and how it does that job. This is also called physiology. When we dissect, we'll refer to it as comparative anatomy because we'll compare the structures of our human organs to those of another organism. If another organism's organs have a similar function, the structures of the organs are likely similar. Now move to the bottom left part of the page where it says four types of tissue. The first type of tissue we'll discuss is muscle tissue. Muscle tissue is responsible for moving things, either material through the organism, such as blood and food, or moving the organism itself. Number two is connective tissue. Connective tissue connects parts to other parts. Examples of connective tissue are bones, ligaments, tendons, cartilage, and even blood. Connective tissue is often found between other types of tissue. The third tissue is nervous tissue. Nervous tissue is responsible for receiving and sending information about your body's internal and external environments. The brain, spinal cord, and all neurons are nervous tissue. The fourth tissue is epithelial tissue. Epithelial tissue makes up the lining of many organs. Epithelial tissue is arranged in lots of different ways depending on the organ and the function of the tissue, but they all share certain characteristics. The linings of the lungs, bladder, intestines, blood vessels, all glands, and many more organs are made of epithelial tissue. Now for the section in the bottom right, homeostasis. Homeostasis is the maintenance of a constant internal environment when outside the organism, conditions change. The body maintains homeostasis by recognizing that conditions are changing and then responding. Electrical messages sent by the nervous system and chemical messages sent by the endocrine system tell the body what changes to make to maintain homeostasis. This concludes our guided notes introduction to this unit. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in class.